Finding diamonds isn't as easy as it used to be, but by the end of this video, you will be full diamond with tons to spare, so you'll be able to flex on your friends quite easily. Before we start though, I just want to say that only 3.6% of my viewers are actually subscribed, so if you're new here, make sure you are subscribed. It's free, and you can always unsubscribe later. So without further ado, here are 10 easy ways to find diamonds in Minecraft 1.19. 1.19 gave us an amazing diamond finding biome, which is the Deep Dark. Not only do mobs not spawn in this biome, but once you get rid of the Skulk Shriekers, you will find a ton of diamonds. And the substance that is around the edge of the caves is called Skulk. What makes this stuff so important is that it tricks the world generation of diamonds. Diamonds have a high chance of being turned to stone or deep slate if they are touching air blocks. However, with the Skulk, it blocks the air. And if you use a hoe, it breaks insanely fast. Kind of like my heart, unveiling tons of diamonds right behind it. Plus, if you have a fortune pickaxe, you'll be able to multiply your diamonds by up to 3 times. But eventually the deep dark caves will end, and your thirst for diamonds may not be quite quenched just yet. Well, if it has come to that, you can always strip mine. However, there are a few variables you need to keep in mind before you do that. First, the Y level that you mine at is very important. At Y level negative 58, diamonds are the most prevalent. However, lava pools slow you down a significant amount, making it somewhat inefficient. Diamonds may also spawn beneath you and get eaten up by bedrock, so it's not a great Y level to mine on. If you do want to mine on the absolute most efficient diamond level, it's Y level negative 57, but you still have to watch out for those lava pools. Nevertheless, you can choose to also strip mine at Y level negative 54. This is the Y level that lava pools start at, so crossing over them is very easy. Diamonds are also still common at this Y level as well, so you should get your fair share. As a bonus tip, you can get all the diamonds in an area if you mine in rows, with a 2-block gap in between each row. This makes sure that you get any diamonds heading in between your columns, and you can go ahead and mine up or down to get any of the diamonds in the absolute area. While you're on your journey, you may encounter ancient cities. Now these are the perfect one-stop shops for diamonds. Around the cities, there lie random pockets of ore that are pretty easily obtainable. Now this could be diamond ore, or this could be iron, gold, lapis, and redstone as well. But you need to be careful around the Skulk Sensors and Shriekers. Because if you're not careful, you'll activate the Warden, and if that happens, you need to be prepared to run. But before leaving, make sure to go ahead and check all the chests. The chest can be filled with enchanted diamond hose and enchanted diamond leggings, so it may save you a few XP levels and diamonds later on. Now the clay method doesn't work anymore, unfortunately, but a brand new method has arisen. If you are mining in either a swamp biome or a desert biome, you may come across fossils. And fossils in these biomes are particularly special, because if they are below Y=0 in these biomes, they are diamond fossils. And if you now mine out the fossil, you will uncover several diamond pockets laying around. But finding fossils are hard, so if you want to find these fossils easily, just do /seed in your world. Go ahead and copy the seed that the world gave you, and then head over to the chunk-based seed map website. Input your seed and select the version that you are in, so that the seed map will be updated below. On that map, you will see a bunch of bones. The bones show you places where there are fossils, and if you hover over those bones, it will tell you the coordinates of those fossils. If the coordinates show that the Y level is below 0, then it is a diamond fossil. Now, the only thing that is stopping you from getting those diamonds is you just going over there and mining down. Now, at this point, I'm going to assume that you were bored of mining. I mean, if mining for hours hasn't gotten you your diamond yield that you think you deserve, is it all that worth it? Well, then stop mining. Yup, stop mining. Build this tunnel bore machine by Misty Cat instead. This machine is super simple, but does require a few scarce materials. It duplicates a TNT, shooting it in front and blowing up a path, moving forward on its own, all with the click of a note block. So now you won't need to swing your pickaxe ever again, until of course you discover some of the beautiful blue gem that was hiding behind the stone. While using your tunnel bore, you may also come across those pesky lava pools again. But this time, you should be excited. If you're on the Java version of the game, go ahead and open up your F3 menu. Once you've opened that, look on the right hand side and you will see something that says target block and then a block underneath. The block that you are currently looking at is shown right there. Using this, we can peer through lava and have them exposed to us by the game, making them an easy treasure to pocket into your inventory. Now, before you leave that lava pool, check to see if you're carrying glass. If you're on the bedrock version of Minecraft and place a piece of glass on the top of the lava pool, you can peer through as if it's not even there. but the only thing stopping you from getting them is your want to scurry over there to that vein. If you are on Java, you can still use blocks like rails, iron bars, and water buckets to check under or near lava for diamonds as well. And this gives you a pretty good advantage, since most of your friends won't be exploring lava pools for diamonds, allowing you to easily become the richest of them all. Believe it or not, one of the easiest ways to find diamonds is directly on the surface. If you are wandering around and see a Badlands biome, make sure you go out and explore it. In these biomes are Badland mineshafts, which are abandoned mineshafts on the surface, exposing minecart chests everywhere. So as you go through and loot the mineshaft, you can find those baby blue gems stashed away just waiting for you. As an added bonus, you can also find crazy OP enchanted books in those chests as well. Exploring Badlands isn't the only way to get diamonds though. They can be found in shipwrecks, minecart chests, desert temples, jungle temples, villages, strongholds, nether fortresses, treasure bastions, end cities, and finally through buried treasure. Which, if you find a buried treasure map, just go to the X, pull out your F3 menu, and look at where it says block on the left. On the right side, there are cords and brackets, and if you go to 99 in these cords and dig down, you will find treasure every single time. Plus, you'll get some other valuable loot like gold, iron, and the heart of the sea. Now, the most efficient way to obtain diamonds in Minecraft currently is, and will most likely always be, from villager trading. There are two ways to get diamonds from villagers. The first way, you want to make an axe and head over to a forest. Chop down as many trees as you can, and once you get around 10 stacks of logs, make yourself some Fletcher tables, a blast furnace, and find yourself a village. Once at a village, craft all your logs into sticks, and place your Fletcher tables down to trade the sticks to the villagers. Once that's done, you should have around 2.5 stacks of emeralds. Now, go ahead and place down the blast furnace and start trading with the armorer. Once you level him up enough, you can start trading the emeralds for diamond leggings and diamond boots. Once you level him up one more time, you can then start buying diamond chest plates and diamond helmets. And that's like mining 24 diamonds by only chopping down trees. Now, the second way is much more OP and way more efficient. If you make a good enough iron farm, you can trade the iron you get with three villager types: the armorer, the weaponsmith, and the toolsmith. These three unlock the ability to trade iron for emeralds on the second level, also known as the apprentice level. As you level up these villagers trading iron with them, they will also unlock other trades as well, like diamond swords, axes, pickaxes, and any other tools as well. Plus, they already have some pretty good enchants on there. If you combine these methods with converting villagers to zombies and reviving them again as well, you can get an insane number of diamond pieces. So you better get building on that iron farm. However, if you don't know how to build one for 1.19 yourself, I have the perfect video for you. Just click on the video that is on the screen now and it will show you how to build the most efficient iron golem farm possible in 1.19. And with that, that's the end of this video. Go ahead and double check to make sure you are subscribed and that you dropped a like on the video. And comment banana if you made it to the end. That way you can go ahead and heart your comment. Have a great rest of your day. Peace.